Once upon a time, my brother said to me, meet us at the sign where the railway goes to the sea. Then stairs go down and down to the shore. My eldest brother lies, dead drunk in an open field. That was his idea of a perfect crime. He was 13 at the time. I was 7. The other brother stands with his back to the sea, waving at a distance. Lex McLean, age 13. Genius.
I'll give you a bargain, 9 shillings. Yeah, for you, 8.
Oh, it's not even worth it.
Look, this is my final offer, 7 shillings.
Your bum's in China.
5 shillings.
Well, I've only got 2.
I thought you said you had 3.
I lied.
Okay, now can we get out of here? Money.
Hairy pans.
What does that mean?
Madness in the family. There you are.
Come on.
You on? Pardon from Big Doug. Actually, it cost a fortune.
Where did you get a fortune?
Saved up for your birthday.
Hello, Lorna.
Lex, I'm your mother. I got these from the warehouse. So what's this?
I don't know.
El Greco.
El Water? We haven't gotten in him yet.
This?
Money.
Huh? And this?
Piero Della Francesco.
Della Francesca.
Alan.
That's Bobby and a good night.
Look, it was an old fish, all right. That's had its day.
She was exactly 2.5 inches long.
There's a whole tub of food in there. Bobby.
vaccine off.
You hands up.
No!
Report to the headmaster, McLean.
Hey, Blake. Come here.
Alan was telling me you're a good wee artist yourself.
No arms. I wonder how he needs his break.
Shut up, Lex.
Lex, it's down here on the right.
Aye, up here.
What?
Are you boys students?
Smell. Oil paint.
Can you see the life model?
Nah, she's just out of sight.
I've never seen a naked woman before. Have you?
Look, we'll just barge in like we're lost, get a good look and then say we're sorry.
Brilliant plan, Alan.
It'll be a good laugh. Come on.
Aye. Can I help you, son?
And the boy says no.
So I was lying in the car, kind of lagging. The girl next to me, soft. Day three of the Glasgow flight.
Just then, a big cloud comes across the sky. I swear, it looked like one of those China ducks, except with a cigar stuffed up his ass. I started to laugh. The girl says, "What is it with you?"
Aye.
She's quiet for a bit. Then she goes, "Christ, so it is." And then she screams. "Oh, what?" I says. She says, "Look at the face on it. It looks just like Charlie Sloan."
Bobby, kill him.
Glenn! Glenn, you bastard!
Lex, hi.
Oh, Uncle Andrew.
Yeah.
Orin andul kongjum hiai hialu meria zahonar shu. Orin andul kongjum hiai hialu meria zahonar shu. Suvairat ok storain moyon stuyak favrons favurat mi.
Woo! Wonderful, Lorna, fantastic.
Bravo. That was brilliant, Lorna.
You should have gone professional.
Aye. You missed the boat, Hen.
It's never too late, Lorna.
Nah, Lorna. Just hand the torch over to your boy here. Remember me when you're a famous artist, son. Van Gogh.
Hey, here.
Andrew, give us a shot.
Come on.
I couldn't follow that.
Go on, give us it.
Okay. Out of the east there came a hard man, oh, all the way from Brighton, oh, glory, hallelujah, cod liver oil and the orange juice.
Do you still have a gravy after bumblebees?
Hey, you boys like art? Let me show you this. This is my ex-wife.
Oh, my God.
Put that away, Andrew. You're upset, Lorna.
What the heck? There's still heaps of room in the front.
My God. He's electrocuted.
Andrew.
Don't worry, he's always doing this.
Out cold.
I'm saying ta-ta, cheerio.
Come on, get your coat and we're going to Jess's.
You all right?
Yeah. Right,
don't stay up too late.
Here's your coat.
Can you walk out
of bed
and tell Bobby his supper's waiting in the oven?
When you go. Have a good time.
You boys get an early night. Look after your mother. And remember, you're my claims.
Yeah.
See my hand.
See if I don't get into art school this year. I could do tattoos.
That's it.
You okay, Lex?
Yeah. Give us some of that.
It's beer.
So?
Here. Get a grip, Lex!
Ah!
Lex, for fuck's sake! Cut it out, Lex!
Help me out! Get me out! What's going on? Here. Bobby.
an offering to keep the peace, okay? Bobby? Lex, come here. Hey! Shite. Lex! You okay, Paul?
Bobby.
A wee bird told me you shot Malky Johnson in the eye.
Malky Johnson? Oh, no.
Who's Malky Johnson?
Hardman. Leads off the Garraside Tongs.
Psychopath!
In the eye? Christ, I've blinded him.
Oh, no.
That's nice, Alan. Don't lose it at school.
Don't worry, Mum.
I'll have it framed, Lorna. Something gold.
Oh, not before he applies to the art school. The frame might seem ostentatious.
Frame makes the picture. Yeah. A little bit of velvet trim would be nice, huh?
Just push it in properly.
What?
What? The paper. Look at it.
Sorry.
All right, Alan. That's okay.
You know my name?
Girls have a knack for these things. Actually, I remember you from primary.
Joanne McGowan?
Yeah. You know, I'm free on Saturday night. Well, you could ask me out or something.
Ask you out? Where?
I don't know. Vince's Cafe? How about it? How about maybe then?
Joanne? Is that Alec?
No, Gran. I'll put some tea on in a minute. 7:30 at the cafe, okay? I'll see you then. Maybe.
Oh, what's this? Hey, what's this here?
Give it back.
Oh, look, it's his mom.
It's his mommy.
Who done it? Your dog.
Very witty.
Oh, come on, Jake, I mean, it's not bad.
No bad. And what do you know?
All right, Lex.
Hey, you. Bobby's brother.
Aye.
Come on up. Bring the wee man too. Oops.
Oh, by the way, remember, don't talk about football, all right? He hates football.
Some collection of books.
Aye. Oh, nicked. May I show you this?
Like it.
Inside pockets. I'll show you how it's done. Hold.
Get the books in the bag!
Take a seat, me man. So, you McLean brothers have been getting quite the reputation.
What?
Shot the leader of the Garrison tongs smack in the nozzle.
I did unusual courage considering Malky heads off a team of going on 200 boys.
Maybe we could buy protection.
Protection in numbers, son. The Glen need lads of your fearless disposition. But you boys need us more than we need you. Let's see. Nice touch. Never thought of being a war artist, recording glorious conquests and all that shite.
I am. If you don't get in the art school, you could be the gang tattooist.
You've been looking at Egan Shields' paintings. Is that right? I've got his book up there. You can borrow it if you like.
Thanks.
I'll buy this portrait off you.
Why?
How does a quid sound?
A quid? I'm not sure. I need it for my art school application, and my mother quite likes it.
All right, all right. Half an hour and the rest when you give me the drawing later.
Aye, okay. I've never sold a drawing before.
Done. Hey, maybe you could do a wee bit of drawing for the Glen. In your official capacity, like. Something nice and easy to start with.
Brilliant.
Look, I'll get back to you when I've thought this through. Only better no mention anything to Bobby. It's a bit over his head, you know.
9:30, double man. Someone got murdered.
You know, it's funny. Sloan's not what I imagined. I thought he was all right.
All right? Aye, sure, Alan. A real working class Medici.
There's just one question.
Aye?
Where's your money?
Where are we going? Straight over the roof,
me. Watch those windows. Sorry, but drop.
Shh. Right.
Arms up.
What? Don't worry. My dad does this for a living.
In you go.
What did Daddy deserve this? Shut up. Just put your legs in and lower yourself down.
Dan. Oh, no.
Do good, wee man.
Oh, no. No!
What's going on down there?
It's an art gallery.
You're Bob and McLean, aren't you? Alan's brother.
Aye. I've seen you around too. I saw you at the skating with Charlie Sloan. Another time down Union Street with the tongs. With that head case, Malky Johnson. How come you're on your own then?
Stood up. What's your excuse?
Oh, I'm waiting for the boys and that.
This is it.
Oh, yes. This is it, all right. Ready, Alan?
You know Big Andy from the fleet? You're not a bad team. Andy chipped Tam at the Lamella. So Tam waited for Andy outside his house. And Andy comes along with his bird.
Only it turns out the bird is the sister of one of Tam's team.
I didn't hear that.
And in point of fact, it wasn't Big Andy. It was Sugar Riley that claimed Tam. And it wasn't stabbing.
Aye, it was. I was there.
Sugar took a hammer to him and knocked out Tam's eye. I know because I was there. So Tam's cousin and his crew get Shuggy's wee brother and drop him 3 floors down the stairwell at Voldora Dance Hall. And Shuggy asks the cousin for a square goal. Only he turns up in the night and Raven clutches his ear with a shotgun. I mean, Christ, Bob, would you want to talk this shite all night?
What do you mean? Alan. Oh, yeah.
Charlie, keep your head still.
Oh, shut up. Perfect, Al. You're an artist. Nobody will ever know.
Charlie. See, Glenn.
Have you seen Alan's mural, Uncle Andrew? It's called Death to the American Paper Tiger.
Paper Tiger, huh?
Mm-hmm.
The mark is not that simple, Alan.
Look, if the Yanks go into Czechoslovakia, it'll be the end. A nuclear war. The total annihilation of the planet.
Is that a fact? The total annihilation of the planet, huh? Amazing. When?
Maybe when you boys are older, you'll come to America. Your dad should have come when he could. He might have had a better life.
Dad was okay.
You didn't know your dad, Lex. You were too young. Strange to think that we were Scots boys like you. Brothers like you. You know, I've been around you boys for over 2 months. Something doesn't feel so good right now. Is everything okay? I'd like to feel if there was something on your mind you could talk to me. Well, I am your only uncle.
There might be something.
Uh-huh.
Mum can't know.
Oh, sure. It's just between us.
Not a word. Promise?
Promise.
You see, it's Bobby. There's a problem. We think he might be a...
Really?
Really. But please don't tell Mum.
Oh, no. Well, Bobby. I guess things today, Bobby, they can, well, I guess it can be a little confusing, huh?
Hey, wee man. Like the motor? Good, because you're in it.
Back of this car. Now, when he hands you, be loaded, would it?
Well, you know, these things are apt to go off at a moment's notice. Very dangerous. Of course it's loaded.
As a matter of fact, we gone for a cup of tea with Malky Johnson. Yeah. Coming. Look, look, come be buds.
Come back!
See, what did I tell you?
Brilliant! Handcuffs!
You're a fucking headcase, slut.
Ah, come on, Shug. Let's not get sentimental.
This is Tongland. There you go, son. Take a walk. Take a walk.
You can't do that, Charlie.
How no? Because they'll cut off his ears and send him back to his ma's special delivery.
No.
Maybe they'll render him unconscious with a hammer and drop him down the nearest manhole.
No.
How about they'll just kill him? Well, what then?
I just think it looks like it's gonna rain.
Aye, so it does. Let it come down, eh, Lexi? All right, let's go.
Why didn't you turn up on our date?
Sorry. Something came up.
It hurt me. You probably can't believe that.
keepsake.
Hello?
Jesus.
Jesus had no brother.
That's great, Alan. I didn't know you could draw.
Yorick, the complete version. Birthday present from Lex, the wee brother.
Happy birthday. Actually, I collect wee brothers. All presents from the Garryside Tongs. This one's from the Young Tongs. This one's from the Tiny Tongs. This one's silver from the Real Tongs. And this one's personal from Malky Johnson.
Malky Johnson?
I know just about everybody, Alan. He's in love with me, so he says. He leads one of the best young teams in the city and he still cries himself to sleep at night. He bangs his head off the wall.
He seems like an animal. Doesn't he scare you?
Not the way you think. I've known Malky since he was 8 years old. He does anything I ask him. Anything but leave me alone. You're an unusual kind of boy, Alan. You don't know that, do you? Fancy some tea?
No.
No. Me neither.
You, son?
Nah, it's not really me.
Okay. Do you want autographs?
Nah. But I know all about Bobby and Alan, Joanne.
You know Bobby and Alan? So?
Well, I'm ready to get quiet about it. In return for certain favours.
Certain favours? You sound like Shakespeare's son. You're fucking Lex, aren't you?
Who's Lex?
Alan told me all about you.
Like what? What did he say?
Mostly good things. Maybe that you're a wee bit active up here. And I met your wee pal, Yorick. So, what kind of favours have you got in mind then, Lex?
I'll need to think about that.
Well, how about you carry these for a start?
Bobby, Sloane wants you.
Here, mind the chin.
Shouldn't you be watching Dr. Kildare?
What?
Where's Alan?
Don't know.
You carrying?
No.
I are. Give it to me and I'll take it in for you. They don't search the girls. I'm with friends. I'll see you inside.
I was 16.
Hey.
Charlie, you're not going to fit through there.
We'll get them when their guard's down. It's a wooden horse of Troy all over again.
Malky's coming tonight. That means full battalion strength.
Can I have my chip back, please?
Sorry, Lex. Confiscated. Go and get some fresh air before Malky gets here.
What's all that about? It's time you let the Glen in.
Can't we just break the window?
No need. The wee man will come and open the window any minute now.
Oh no. Shit.
Right, boys, here we go.
Jesus, Mary and Joseph, it's the Glen.
Get out of the way, we're coming in.
Oh, dead scary, so yous are. You get my friend scared too. She's trembling. Come on, Jeannie, come and take a look at the Glen. You'll be all right. Christ, what's that? A tail of the hun?
Fuck you.
I seen in the fucking laboratory. Do you remember Big Andy McCutcheon that got killed in the green?
Yeah.
You remember the hands on him?
Yeah.
Somewhere in this city is a deranged scientist hell-bent on creating the ultimate half man, of which Keith is a bungle prototype.
Huh.
You're
a murderer. You destroy that monster here now.
Hey, Malky, you've got a visitor. Come on, we'll get him in a second.
What time do you call this?
Ma, I'm 18.
But you're not, Lex.
I've been worried sick.
Where did you get that shirt?
I found it.
Brand new. It must have cost at least £3.
I found it.
He's a real liar. Lex, you stole it.
No!
Did you steal that shirt? And I don't need that from you!
How's it me all of a sudden?
Get to bed. All of you just get out of my sight.
How, eh? How?
Shut it, Lex. Give. Bed.
These are really good ones.
That's it, in a sketchbook.
What do you mean? Come on, Lex, let me see it. Let me see it, come on.
No, it's nothing.
Lex, that is brilliant. I've never seen myself like that before.
You think I'm an idiot, don't you?
Lex, we stop carrying on. I think it's excellent.
Admit it, it's rubbish.
Will you shut up? Lex, it's a very, very good drawing. You like that? It's Perugia in Italy.
Have you been there?
Aye. You should see it. I mean, I always spent the summer with my dad. We stayed by a river. You know, it's funny. I had a dog. I mean, I felt like I belonged there. But I was a stranger, really. And grown men hug each other in the street.
Ugh.
Look at this.
What an amazing object.
It's for you. A present.
But are you sure? I mean, it looks valuable.
I found it.
Really? Where did you find it?
In a bin, actually.
Lex, you're blushing. Hi, Dad. That's right. Wrapping his vines against the frost. 15 years and no a single grape. Vines in the middle of Scotland.
Hey, you. What's your name?
What?
Never mind what. Ask your name.
Handsome, isn't he?
Aye, what plastic.
Look, excuse me.
Look at it. Couldn't he point its way at a paper bag?
Big fight come with the tongs today. How come you're not with the Glen? You're too good for them.
Betty fights like a lassie.
Well, I don't fight with girls.
Go oh, for it, girl!
Tells you, okay?
What's happening here?
I'm second in this team.
Welcome to it, Bobby.
It's best to throw them broken.
Aye, very good, Bobby.
Hey, wee man, come and say hello to your Uncle Charlie.
No chance.
Come on. Come on. Lexi.
Oh, for fuck's sake, Sloane.
Oh, she's being affectionate.
Bobby. Where's Johnson? Malky Johnson.
Come on, Sloane.
Come on, Sloane!
Still get your looks.
Oh,
who did this? Was it Bobby?
No!
Johnson's well clear!
Fuck it, Tom!
Yes!
You're dead! Glenn, you're back! Easy!
Always good to me.
You, we get jumped today. There's an informer, a clay pigeon.
So what the fuck's a clay pigeon?
Are you taking the piss?
Aye. All right, Bobby. Whatever you say. A clay pigeon.
What's going on here?
Oh, nothing. Just this time, B-O-B-B-Y went for a W-A-L-K.
Lex.
I'm saying that he's a M-O-R-O-N.
Lex. What's he saying? Never mind him, Bobby. Did you hear about Fabio?
What?
The team got him, that's what. Basket case! Jesus, Bobby. Do you remember when we were kids? Do you remember Dad?
What?
No. Do you remember? I couldn't do anything wrong. But he was always on at you. Do you remember that?
No.
You must do, Bobby. You're older than me.
As a matter of fact, and you never knew this, but before he died, he apologised to me.
Fuck, Bobby. That's just crap and you know it.
No, it isn't!
Not much of a footballer, are you, son?
I saw you earlier.
That's right. I scare easily.
You and the tongs?
Nah, I'm a pacifist. Between you and me, the tongs is a load of crap.
What's your name?
Garbles. My family moved for the Garbles 2 years ago. My real name's George. That's a cracking shot.
Thanks. I was thinking of joining the Tongs.
How old are you, son?
13. You?
16.
You're awful wee for 16, Garbles.
I smoke a lot.
You know the Tongs, then?
Know them? A lovely one. It's my stepbrother. Here.
It's just me, a stepbrother, and two stepsisters, and me Harry, so she get put away.
No adults?
Nah, they live their own lives next door.
But isn't that against the law or something?
We don't really see much of the law down here. Anyhow, it's like a kind of experiment. Like a kibbutz. Maria?
Lex?
Have a seat, Lex.
Is he going out?
He's due back.
Hey, Maria.
Thanks, Malky.
Malky?
Malky, there's a boy to see.
I'm going to Saturday. Malky, if I take LSD, will I see Wee Dwarf too?
Oi!
Introduce the boy to you, Malky. His name's... What's your name again?
Lex.
Lex?
What are you staring at?
I'm not. He's here to join the Tongs, Malky.
The Tongs? Do you know what mental is, son?
No.
Mental's... nothing gets in your way, do you know what I mean? It's a state of mind. It's like a wee boy comes into your house. I mean, he's really wee, maybe 13. But you don't like his face, so you stab him anyway. Mental's doing time for murder because you don't give a fuck. Do you think you could do that, son? Do you think you could be mental?
Aye.
Where are you from? Postle Street?
No. Govan Hill.
What? Govan Hill, Garbles. What's going on here?
He wants to join your team, so I brought him up, because he seems all right.
And what's Tom's going to do with a stunted midget for Glenland?
I don't know, maybe a spy? Yeah, a spy.
Yeah.
So, what's he going to tell us? What do you know about Charlie Sloan?
Well, he's kind of... Sloan's very fat. He lives with his dad. I think he reads a lot. Well, what do you mean, what do I know?
How about Joanne McGowan? Is Sloan screwing her?
No. No, he isn't.
So you know Joanne McGowan?
No. No, I don't.
So how do you know Sloan isn't screwing her?
Oh, easy on, Malky. She's just a wee bird, you know.
Welsh, am I the leader of this team?
So?
So, don't embarrass me. I've got company. If I wanted to find Bobby McLean on his own, how would I do that?
I don't know, but I think Charlie Sloan goes skating on Saturday mornings.
That's Sloan? I asked about Bobby McLean.
He's a slow thinker, a bit of a mummy's boy, a bad temper. I don't know, he's very unpredictable.
What about McLean's brothers?
What brothers?
Fucking useless. Well, take this wee shite out in the stairs.
Hang on a second, Malky. He said something about Sloan going skating.
So, Sloan goes skating. Where? Cross Maloof? With his team?
No, with a couple of girls, I think.
No team?
No.
Oh, mind you, that was a while back.
Oh, that was a while back, Welsh.
No, he goes every week. He told me personally.
Who knows? I've never had a spy before. Saturday morning. Be there.
Corbels, show him out.
I just wanted to say it's been wonderful to see you. All of you. Really? I feel like a new person. A man can feel like a failure sometimes if...
Andrew, your taxi's waiting.
Yeah. Well, if you ever get tired of Glasgow, there's always Seattle.
We know, Andrew.
I need to talk to you.
What about? What did you want to talk about?
Nothing special. I just thought we should talk.
Maybe Gorbals would like to talk to us now.
Just nod if the answer's yes.
It's a verdict.
You don't want to know.
Try me.
The wee shite is Bobby McLean's brother, Lex McLean.
That's not good.
No, it gets better. This is great. In fact, he's the one that shoots me in the head with an air gun, remember? And now the other brother's screwing my girlfriend. I mean, you've got to hand it to them. That's a remarkable family.
Beautiful, Alan. I don't mean me, I mean it.
I'll treasure it. Always.
Where are you going?
Skating. It's a regular thing with me and Polly.
Just the two of you?
Well, actually, Charlie's flown as well. It's his weekly outing.
You can't go out with every hard man in Glasgow, you know.
Look, you don't know him. All he wants to do is go round the ice with me and Polly and hold our hands. Round and round, okay? That's all there is to it. You should see the face on him like a wee boy.
Do you know what that guy's capable of?
Listen, I don't meet these rules, Alan, okay?
Well, you can't go out with him anymore. That's it.
That's it?
Yeah.
Well, you know what you can do with your that's it, don't you?
Oh, yeah.
So solemn at his age.
So, Aunt Lorna, how about a song?
Oh, no. Get the door, Lex. Lex?
What's up with him? Don't know. Some kind of trance, probably.
Orin andur cum hium o chiar Chiar o meria sa honas tio Su vairat hoc storain molion Stuyak favrons, favulat mi.
Thank you.
Hey, missus! Better watch out for that wee boy. He's a murderer, you know.
You're dead, son!
Hey, missus, come here!
Hey, killer! Tongs!
Mum.
You go out and find the animals that murdered your brother. That's what you can do. Murderer.
Are you taking the piss out of me?
How do you mean?
I mean, okay, you were at the skating, but you didn't know what was going to happen.
So how's it your fault? Because it is.
How could you have killed your own brother?
I starved.
Look, Lex, Malky knows all about you and Alan.
Alan? What's it got to do with Alan?
Look, just get out of here, okay? Somewhere very far away.
Like where?
I don't know. Edinburgh, maybe? Look, it's against my principles. But you'd better take this.
What's that wee man?
Do you think I'm a bad person?
It's about Alan and Malky Johnson, Charlie.
Ah, Malky. The twisted, lovesick vampire. Sorry, wee man. Can't help you. Strictly organised crime from now on.
Organised crime? So is that why you're doing the shopping for your mammy? You're a washout, son.
Midnight, Mum. You not asleep?
I can't sleep. There's tea in the pot. And tell Lex to go to bed at once.
Lex?
Isn't he with you? I thought he was with you.
No. Oh, God, I hope he's okay. It's so late.
I should have known something like this was going to happen. Everything this family's been through. I'm angry at him. I'm angry at him. I'm so angry I don't even know if I care if he comes home.
you're dead!
Gavin Hill, 3056. Lex. Lex, is that you? Lex, don't hang up again. Go to school today?
No, not really. The exams are over.
Stay with me today, will you?
Malky says you have to come to his place now. You just need to talk. Please.
Marbles. Where is she?
She wasn't in.
You brought out Lex McLean here, didn't you?
Aye, but...
Well, he came back. With this. So, where is he now? And it better be the truth. Thousands wouldn't.
And do a handstand for your Uncle Andy?
No.
Now, whose birthday is it this week?
Heard the good news. Malky Johnson's dead.
What?
So don't look so happy.
The bastard's history now.
It was an accident.
Sure, ask the police. Only it wasn't. Because I did it. So now I'm the killer, okay? I saved you. That whore Joanne. That idiot brother of yours. I saved you and you owe me. I murdered the fucker. And now I'm mental.
It just happened, Carmels. It doesn't mean you caused it.
You'll never guess, will you, Lex? It was just an accident, wasn't it?
You'll be all right. You'll be fine.
Good. Because I'm the leader of the Tongs now.
Over here. So... I hear you've been acting a bit strange lately.
How? Where's your grandmother?
She had to go to a nursing home.
But she's your gran.
It's better for both of us.
But that means that
you... Just drop it, Lex.
Something else.
What?
Can I have my shoe back, please?
You know I'm going to London, Lex.
But what about Alan?
What about Alan?
Well, you love him.
Love him? I'm 17 years old, Lex.
Well, how about I come instead then?
Yeah, right, Lex. Maybe in a couple of years.
In a couple of years, you'll be 19.
So?
I mean, 19? There again, you'll need anybody that'll take you by then.
How's it going to be all right?
You can't see things that far ahead. Trust me.
If you can't see things that far ahead, how do you know it's going to be all right?
Because I'm older than you, remember? Come on. I'll see you as far as the door.
Round about then, Lorna had a dream. Bobby wasn't dead. He'd gone north and joined the fishing fleet. Years passed, he made friends. He was even popular. And they came to think of him as an interesting and wise person. Uncle Andrew married Lorna and came to live in Govan Hill. Just my luck. The only American who ever emigrated to Scotland. Alan went to art school and moved into his own flat. Sometimes he comes home for a square meal. I don't worry about him anymore. My dream was different, more like a nightmare. I grew hair all over me, I had body odour, and I suffered from uncontrollable senseless impulses. Yet I felt responsible for everything. I dreamt I was a man. Luckily, when I woke up, I was still a boy.